Hello, welcome back. Waiting for that noise. Well, we're gonna head back to Cadnor. We gotta turn in the Warrior Chief Iklak's head. Out of any of the names, I remember Warrior Chief Iklak for some reason. These are the quests we have, not that much. The main quests. I have to find out more about Leaden Key's activities, and I need to gain a level to get into Cleoban Relaq. Grieving Mother, we gotta pick her up at some point and do that quest. Palagina. Yes, that's pretty much the main thing we're gonna be heading towards now. That we're not doing, because I don't want to kill the guy. It's the only way out. That's the falls. Again, we gotta head back there at some point. I want to gain a level before I head back to do this. That name, the Drake or Dragon, is very tough. The Long Hunt, we gotta pick her up and do that at some point. Endless Pass, Endless Pass. Durance. Yeah. Okay, so we'll get to know Durance as we continue along. Probably the main quest, I'm guessing. He'll reveal more and more. So we're gonna head back to the Endless Pass, otherwise, and do a couple levels there.
No problem.
Every once in a while I'll just do a couple levels out of that, because I hear it's quite the expansive dungeon. Oh crap. Hold on a second. Sounds a little lame, but I'm gonna meet you guys there. Because I want to get another camping supply. Okay. I did buy my one camping supply kit. And I slept. I decided to give myself the lore bonus this time. Probably not the best idea. But I feel that whatever we're going to be encountering, we're going to be encountering lore because of the quest. What are we supposed to be finding down there? The master below. Yes, guys, you read all that. Here, have this head.
How do you do?
War Chief Iklak is dead. Dun dun. That ought to make the Veilwood a little safer for a time. Here's your reward. Anything else? More bounties? We can do this over and over again? Yeah. I don't want to do it all again. Cool. We can't return to Grimda. She wants to attack us. And then, that again, that's down below. And the kid, as I've seen before, I'm not giving him a knife, sorry. Else added. Oh no, really. Down into the dungeons with us. I bet there's a quicker way, but how you doing? Alright. I'm gonna just fly through here. Hopefully there's not wandering monsters. At least the stairs are rather close. We've been to level 2 as well, and cleared that out, as far as I know. We had 2 ways down. You climb down this rope or something, which is over here. Or go down those stairs. I'd rather go down the stairs. I'd rather be able to come... get back up. Once I... Okay, you're gonna go through that way. Alright. Alright, level 3, guys. Slowly now. Shh! Our first time. Level 3. Mm-hmm. Interesting. Not background messages. No. No, say it ain't so. Though worn away by time, many of these alcoves are engraved with Edirian surnames. Yep. I have vowed to explore all content, so... That's why I read all these guys. They're interesting as well, you know. Nicholas Prote Deir Corax. Spiritus Tristus Exicat Ossa. Korzig Gizrock. A little too late. Destiny or fate. Proverbial foot loose. So, I drink it. Characters. I cannot read that. Patricia Young Spitzley. Loving grandmother. Rest in peace, 1919 to 2014. Not in this age, friend. Radek Smektala. They called him Radek and thought he thought himself a bard. He craved recognition. He dreamed very hard. Alas, he never sang. His song stayed in his mind. For the heart to face the crowd he never did find. Radwolf, the grave robber. His last word was, "Calm down, it's just a skeleton." Rejexus. Sit down, drink some coffee, eat a hearty meal, relax, and eat all... let all your troubles wash away. P.S. Thank you, Obsidian, for developing this game. Also, thank you to all the backers for funding this game. No thanking for breaking immersion. Callum. They said I wasn't talented or artistic enough to create a game, and they were right, but by throwing money at people who are, I can get a thank you in the credits. It counts. Suck it, Mr. Patterson. Who's Mr. Patterson? Rowan Greycastle. It isn't my fault. I didn't know I was breaking a peace conference. It was supposed to be a warning to a bunch of bandits. But you have to admit, it was a really good shot. Raytheon. Only by severing the chains of fate are you free to follow your destiny. Old Man Ryan. Lost both eyes staring at the morning sun and died as he had lived, of old age. Nicholas Delaney. To our youngest brother who passed suddenly in a wilderness adventure, your life was cut short, but you will forever live on in our hearts. You are loved and you are missed every day. B. Rosen. Wat mot dat mot. Dr. Ray Muzia. Muzica. Friend of Obsidian, co-founder and former CEO of BioWare, sponsored an NPC Daeon based on a mage character used to play in D&D as a lad. Raistlin, spelled differently. Raistlin the 11th. I drew poorly from the deck of many cards and ended up being this rock. People like to write on me for some reason. Mar, the Eternal Lightbringer. Richard Andrew Clark. A son, a brother, a writer, a volunteer. Kaselahi McGinko. Okay, that music came on very suddenly. I would like to thank Obsidian for the entertainment, my family for their love, and the Federated States of Micronesia for my home. This is a new theme. Awesome. Is it themed just for the dungeon? Which way do we go? Which Trap.
Now this I haven't seen before.
Do you think, Durrance?
That's settled.
Leather armor and a crested hat. That's not worth trapping. Oh, I got the experience. Not a very hard trap either. Four difficulty. Jean-Michel Petit, I know why you're here. Enjoy. Servin the beggar. He coughed, hacked, and spat a large lump upon the ground. The beggar's final word shall live on. My lung! It's flopping all over the dirt! Damn. Semael the butter dragon. For Cato and Chrissy. From changeless knoll to fey and flux, my love for always. Conrad Chin. I am an EOD tack. If you see me running, try and catch up. Yorn Grote. I don't know. Gaming has given me so much love over the years that I'm happy to give something back. Also, there is no rest, no limit, no end to the beyond. Furthermore, to the infinite numbers of levels above. Great old one. Yeah, Cthulhu, yeah, whatever. Class Nordmark. To the memory of Jinyan's last Cerbomancer. Daniel Morgan. Here lies Daniel Morgan, the pirate lord, who left his foes battered and topsy-turvy. No man can kill me, he boastfully scored, and 'twas true enough, for he died of scurvy. Holkan and Yanni. This one thing every tyrant will tell you, nothing saves more lives than murder. Covenant. I want to see adventure, cried the Neve, and so he set out upon an epic quest. Not 3 days thence we write upon this grave these words at his parents' grieving bequest. Wait, we started here. There's more. Gah, Sticky Fingers Sada. His baklava was unsurpassed, but as a thief he was half-assed. Timo Kajander. It's just a flesh wound. Second best swordsman. Anton K. Sadly, the engraving looks like utter gibberish. Rydier. Don't mind me. Ryladair Fellblade. Liberator of villages, slayer of kings, deceiver of dragons. It was that last part that got him killed. Ryaku. Look behind you. Shate. The world was not made for saints. That's why scoundrels rule the world. I don't advise changing the world, but we can always use more saints. That's it.
You can trust me.
I just want to check this. And I don't know if we're close to somebody evil, so I'm still gonna sneak. Yeah, I looked at all these. Okay. Just making sure. Gotta read them all. Let's go this way. Some big, interesting bridge that way, but we'll go this way for now. Oh, wow. Thulgar? We can speak to this one? You're mighty big. Don't skulk. Come into the light. There's nothing in this... Oh, there is something there. Well, what do you what have to say, you Thulgar? Cast in orange hues by the guttering torches, a massive creature sits at the rear of this wide chamber. There is an acrid stench of blood and offal about the room, and a hot, malodorous gust wafts towards you as the ogre rises, stirring up the dust beneath its feet. If they had only known how many unwitting fools would wander into my camp, I would not have been exiled. Despite his words, the ogre studies you dispassionately. His pale, grim features are streaked with dried blood. But then I think they have lost the taste for elf, now that they have feasted on one another for so long. The ogre turns away. I will not be fattened for the eating. Number four. Who are you? I am Thulgar, once most trusted of Zala's warriors. Once, the ogre shrugs a shoulder. It matters not. Go but a little way south, and you'll find what became of us. Once a dozen strong, and now we are nothing. Our great chief, enraged by voices, and our people driven to devouring one another. And I, the coward, wait here to die alone. Easier said than done. He gestures to a heap of bones and cloth. Hunger has a will of its own. Matron Zala knows that as well. What happened to your leader? Matron Zala. She was plagued with dreams from the moment we came here. Terrible dreams of something down below. She was convinced we should not go there. Thulgar lowers his head. I told her it was nothing. Thought nothing of it, until we discovered the poison within the Zareps. It changed her. Whatever the voice spoke, she grew harder, colder. Perhaps it was enough that the voice was never silent through all those days and nights. Perhaps the poison made the dreams all the worse. It is harder, perhaps, to see madness in those closest to you, but I should have seen it all the same. Too late for that now. You're all starving? Isn't there something to eat down here? We have lived here for many years. The caverns have changed around us. Many old tunnels have been closed. Perhaps it's the spider's doing. For a time, we feasted on the Zoreps and lived well. But the Zorep tribes have become diseased, poisoned. I'll make sure not to eat them. We did not notice at first. Not until we, too, began to grow weak. Some of us became like fellow creatures, maddened by the poison. Matron Zala, strongest of us, she did not go so easily. Her madness came slowly. Some of us went on eating the Zoreps, of course. Even knowing. There was nothing else. They died painfully, but quickly. Others tried venturing out into the Great Stair, trying to find a way out. Zala forbade us from leaving, in time. If we could not find anything to hunt, then some of us, she said, must sacrifice themselves. I hesitate to put an end to either of them. I mean, I think the right thing should be, should I put an end to this, Zala? Rather than just state it. You're cannibals? Yes, we have come to that. Even I have tasted it. There is no returning from that, I think. I will remember the moment for what remains of my life. Okay, I'm not going to attack him. And, I'm going to not say that I'm going to put an end to Zala. I should be going. Wait. Thulgar looks down at you. You must be powerful to venture through these caverns. There are far worse creatures than even us down below. He takes in a deep breath. Perhaps you are strong enough to put an end to Zala. Okay, now he's asking us. Okay, so that changes things. I cannot raise a hand against her. She is my mate still. Eternally. I have tried to bring myself to do it many times. Perhaps I would fail, but I cannot even try. Even though her madness... She has spared me. Please, I beg you to do this thing for me. Bring me her torque, and I will at last know that it is over. I'll do it. Then strike well. She will not hesitate to put you upon the spit, if you should fail. And if she falls, return to me. I would know of it. It's bound to be a hell of a combat in itself. Creatures down below notwithstanding. yep, pretty much. Bring the torque as proof. Another camping supply and a bloodstone. I'm guessing these... Okay, they're not his. Pardon me, sir. We have some background messages to read. Nemo! Everyone has a story waiting to be told. Let it out, and the world will be richer for it. Nina. Nothing. Neon Azari. Good morning. Naman. I Aetent Dead. Obsidian Razor. Born in fire between earth and stars, wandered the realms of men, sailed the seas of lore, plumbed the eternal depths, soared the celestial skies, died a hero's death, fades into oblivion. Oleg. A day will come when hearts like torches blaze with light. Edwin Tiong. He died as he lived, screaming in terror while wielding a sock with a half brick in it in each hand. Nelson Alves. Nothing. Valeska the actress. There was no role she could not play, so natural in talent, so powerful in conviction, so good, in fact, was she, that we are not entirely sure she's deceased. Character name protagonist. In loving memory of simpler times, Paul D. He departed almost as quickly as he had arrived, a founding member of the Obsidian Order, seeking balance, he wandered off into the night, never to be seen again. Pendaren. Alone in a crowd, bright but invisible, carried gold but no wealth, a caring heart with no emotion, a wizard with no magic. Droxel Bonebiter. It's not what you think it is. Paralas, LBY. Reality is that distinct personal universe derived from one's own conceptual view of normality. Alexei Rakowish. Go for the eyes, boo! Go for the eyes! Rag! Graham Tyson. He has gone to meet his maker. Whether his maker is prepared for the great ordeal of meeting him is another matter. Vyashlev Ploptis. Keep calm and carry on. Pride, the mother of all sin. Done. At least these ones are kind of shorter. Okay, so as far as I can tell, we only have one way to go at this point.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
I'm kind of glad that we went there first. So where's this ogre tribe? And how soon till we meet them? And how hard will they trounce us? My guess is they might be in there. There's an ogre. Thought I heard footfalls.
Following your lead.
Okay, we didn't have much chance for that. Did I hit that right? Don't bother getting up.
That's it.
And they fall hard, don't they? Those chunks flew up into the air. It's a peridot and ogre blood. Bottled for our convenience.
Laying low.
Eh?
I hear more footfalls. You know what? I don't think we've looked at ogre in the bestiary. Ogres are large, thick-skinned creatures standing between 10 to 12 feet tall. They are heavily muscled and typically attired in the furs or skins of their prey. Clubs, axes, and maces of bone or wood are their preferred weapon. Ogres are as intelligent, often more so, than civilized races, but their overwhelming hostility towards even their own species keeps their numbers low. Despite their natural intelligence, their volatile temperaments have historically prevented them from concentrating long enough to create anything of significant cultural value. Most live semi-nomadic, secluded lives in the wilderness, where they are less likely to encounter others. The only time they reliably come together is during the mating season, which often does almost as much to reduce their numbers as it does to replenish them. Ogres with a more peaceful streak take particular pains to avoid contact. On the rare occasions that ogres are found working together, they are almost always operating under the directions of an ogre matron. Ogre matrons are even larger than male ogres, but tend to be less aggressive toward their own kind. Where ogres have banded together, they have often represented an insurmountable threat to other kith.
No problem.
And go. There's another one now. Oh, there's another one behind him. Oh, this is going to be heavy. Switch to melee. I think one of us switched to the wrong one. And Ken is always switching to the wrong one. Let's spare a bounding missile, concussive missile. Yeah. Minoletta's concussive missiles. You know, it should be easy to take one over. Should I bother?
Yeah.
Faith.
But Moen.
That's it.
Oh boy. Okay, lay on hands. Did we? It failed, I guess? Well, yeah, you typically think of them as dumb, but they are intelligent. I guess someone hit him after that and brought him out of it. Because that was quick. Clear out! I forgot that. I keep forgetting that feature for Adair. Oh, I gotta choose my... Well, I should wait for him to get up first, right? Can he reach that one? No, he's not gonna be able to reach that one. Okay, never mind. I don't want him running all over the place and getting... You can hit this one, though. Obviously, duh. Fire burns! Soul ignition. That was near death.
I'm ready.
Knock him down again. You are hitting, right, Kana? I don't think he was even doing anything. These ogres seem to be a unique breed, if only you could speak with them. If only you guys would all attack, like you said. Ba-boom. Well, we did speak with one of them. They all have these peridots in their own blood, which makes sense.
Keeping an eye out.
There's another one.
Got it.
I want to see what's in this box. Some copper. End of the line here. Carol Galan. Okay. Well, we still have this way to travel. But we're gonna go this way. And we'll do that. Ta-da! Next episode. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. And endure. In enduring, grow strong.